In this chapter, you'll learn how to install and configure the Graphisoft BIM server on your computer in order to provide a safe and solid teamwork environment for all the members of the extended design team. Please note that you need to set up and configure the BIM server only once. Then you'll be ready to share as many projects as you wish. Now let's start installing the BIM server. Insert the Graphisoft ArchiCAD installation DVD in the DVD drive of your computer and launch the ArchiCAD installer by clicking on its icon. You can also download the BIM Server installer package from the myarchicad.com website after registration. Run the BIM Server installer program by clicking the Install Graphisoft BIM Server button on the main page of the Install menu. The installation program is started. Click the Next button in the installer. After reading carefully, select the I Accept radio button to accept the license agreement and click Next to continue. You may change the installation folder and the application folder if you wish. After setting the desired folders, click Next to continue. Click the Install button on the summary page to start the actual installation. Please provide administrator privileges to the installer to make changes on your computer and enter your password if required. After the installation is complete, you will be asked to specify the necessary settings to configure the BIM server. As a first step, give the BIM server a name by which you will be able to identify it. This becomes important when there are several BIM servers running in one office. Select the Use Computer's Name radio button, displaying your local computer's name, and click Next. Now, select a folder where all the shared teamwork projects will be stored. This folder should not be used for other externally linked non-teamwork files, such as drawings from non-teamworked PLNs, DWGs, JPEGs, and so on. This folder should only be used for teamwork projects that will be handled by the BIM server itself. By default, the location for the Projects folder is a subfolder of the BIM Server Program folder. For the sake of this training guide, we will use this folder. You will be able to change the location of this folder later in the BIM Server Control Center application, but if you do so, you will have to reshare your projects. It's advisable to use a dedicated folder for your teamwork projects outside the application folder. Click the Next button to proceed. The next page allows you to select a folder where the BIM Server libraries will be stored. By default, this is the attachment subfolder of the BIM Server Program folder. We will use this folder for now. Please note that you will not be able to change the location for this folder later on. Click the Next button to proceed. On the next page of the dialog, you'll need to create at least one new user. This user will be the BIM Server Administrator. The Server Administrator manages the BIM Server. This person has the right to create new projects on the server and create new users or roles, or modify or delete existing ones. In this case, we will have a person who is the lead architect in our architectural team and will also be the server administrator. Let's create this administrator account. Fill out the fields in the dialog box as detailed below. Please enter a password that you will remember easily. The email address you specify here will be used by ArchiCAD to send your password to in case you forget it. However, as long as you have access to the computer that hosts the BIM server, you can change the password or create a new administrative account within the BIM Server Control Center. Please make sure to correctly type uppercase and lowercase characters since the username and password are case sensitive. In the following dialog box, you can specify that the BIM server be accessible from outside the office over the internet and set up different port options in case the default ones are already taken. For the sake of this training, we will not set either of these options. However, let's open the sub-dialog boxes just to see which parameters can be set. Click the Modify button in the Access field to go to this dialog. Here you can specify either an IP address, for example 172.16.1.1, or a web address, for example twserver.graphisoft.com, to allow access to the BIM server over the internet. If you leave the address field blank, no access will be allowed from outside the office. Leave the address field blank for the purposes of this training guide and click the Cancel button to return to the previous dialog. Click the Modify button in the Ports field to go to its dialog. As you can see, there are four ports. ArchiCAD sets them to certain default values, and normally you do not need to modify these. These ports are used by the various components of the Teamwork solution for communication between the server and clients. Click the Cancel button to leave this dialog box unchanged. Check the Start BIM Server with Operating System checkbox. Checking this checkbox means that the BIM server will automatically start up every time the operating system starts. We advise that you check this checkbox so you do not have to start the BIM server each time you wish to continue this training. You will have the option to uncheck this option in the BIM Server Control Center. Click the Next button to proceed. In the dialog box below, you can specify an SMTP server used to send email reminders about user passwords. Fill out the required fields, and then click Next to continue. You have now provided all the necessary data for setting up the BIM server. Click the Finish button to start the BIM server. You have now been redirected to the BIM Server Installation Program to finalize the installation. On the next page, check the type of shortcut that you want created for the BIM Server application. We suggest that you at least create a Quick Launch icon on Windows or the Dock icon on Mac. Then click Next to continue. On the next page of the installer, make sure the Start Graphisoft BIM Server checkbox is checked. Please note that software updates might be available for the installed BIM Server package. We will install these shortly. Click Finish to complete the installation of the BIM Server. Please provide administrator privileges to complete the installation if necessary. The BIM Server is now started and will be running with all the required configurations completed. The BIM Server Control Center application is also displayed. Please note at the top of the Control Center dialog that a new update is available for download. Click this text to open the download page in your default browser. The BIM Server Update page opens. Click the Download Now button to download the update package. Please note that it's recommended to disable virus checkers on Windows operating systems during BIM Server updates. Start the Hotfix application once its download is completed. Click Open to start the software update. Please note that not only the BIM Server, but also the BIM Server Manager, as well as all ArchiCAD instances on all workstations, should also be updated with the same hotfix. Working in Teamwork requires that the BIM Server, the BIM Server Manager, and all connected client ArchiCADs have the same build number. Please install this hotfix on all other BIM servers and ArchiCAD workstations as well. In our case, ArchiCAD has already been updated, so let's click Next to proceed. Before installing the hotfix, we should make sure that neither the BIM Server Control Center nor the BIM Server Manager is being accessed by remote desktop, because both of these BIM Server processes will be shut down throughout the update. Let's click Next to proceed. Let's click Next again to update the BIM Server Manager as a component of the BIM Server. Finally, click Install to start the update process. Please provide administrator privileges to proceed if necessary. After the installation is completed successfully, click the Finish button to close the Hotfix installation dialog. A new icon will appear in the Windows taskbar or at the top menu bar of the Mac. This is the BIM Server icon. The icon shows the state of the BIM server by its color. Green means the BIM server is running. Red means that the BIM server has been stopped or is not running yet. Hover your cursor over the Graphisoft BIM server icon in the Windows taskbar or in the Mac menu bar to see basic data about the BIM server, including status, name, IP address, and so on. In this chapter, you've seen how simple it is to install the Graphisoft BIM server. The Graphisoft BIM server configured in just a few steps during the installation process. It is set to automatically start up after system restart, with no need for any manual input from the administrator.